Hello, my name is Holly, and this is my dog Stella, who's falling asleep. I make videos here on YouTube with Stella all about the Dachshund life, all the adventures we go on, and just tips and tricks for your own puppies and dogs. Today's video has been highly requested. I get so many questions about house training and what's best when it comes to crates and puppy pads and schedules and all that kind of stuff. So that's what today's video is about. But first, I want to talk about a giveaway that we have going on. Leica is a pet company and they sent over some products for me to try, and they're gonna give some products to one of you guys. I'm hosting a giveaway, so if you wanna hear the details of that, make sure you stay tuned for the next few minutes. They make very modern looking pet tools, so I've got this slicker brush and nail grinder. If you watch my grooming video, you know that I prefer the nail grinder to clippers just because Stella is less reactive to the grinder. And this one is my new favorite. It's got a little spot here to grind and there's a hole at the top. And to turn it on, you just spin this little wheel, and then to make it stronger, you turn it further, which I really like because on my other one, there was only two speeds and you had to choose between the two. This one has a spectrum, so you can choose how fast you want it to go. And the brush, my favorite feature is that you can pop the bristles out and pop them back in, so it's self-cleaning. Basically, you pop them out when you want to use it, and then you do your brushing. I think Stella actually likes being brushed. And then whatever fluff is on there, you pull the bristles back, the fluff will stay there, and it's very easy to clean and wipe it off. I just love how sleek looking the designs are. Like, I love very basic neutral colors. But my favorite product of theirs is their poop bags. There's one missing because I've been using it for the past week. They just look like regular rolls of poop bags, but what makes them really special is they are extremely environmentally friendly because they're 100% biodegradable. They're made from cornstarch, so that definitely helps reduce your plastic footprint that you leave on the earth, which I'm all about environmentally friendly stuff. Another thing that I love about them is how easy it is to open them. That took 2 seconds. Usually when Stella poops on a walk, I have to stand there and for like 5 minutes try and separate the two pieces of plastic to open up the bag, and it's just so awkward and awful. That's a huge thing for me, how easy it is to open. And if you want to purchase anything from their website, you can use the code STELLA15 for 15% off. I'm also hosting a giveaway on Stella's Instagram. So if you're interested in getting a nail grinder for free, head over to Stella's Instagram and then you can read about all the rules over there. But anyways, back to today's video, house training. House training a Dachshund is hard. If you Google hardest breed to house train, Dachshund is literally the first one that comes up on Google. Obviously, not all Dachshunds are the exact same. Every time I make a general statement about the breed, I get people commenting saying, but mine's not like that, mine's like this, mine's different. Not every single Dachshund is difficult to house train, but I would say the general majority are. Obviously, there are exceptions, but I would say as a general blanket statement, Dachshunds are known to be very stubborn, and that's what makes them difficult to house train. I really, really struggled Stella's first few months with house training, and it felt very defeating, feeling like I was doing something wrong because she wasn't getting house trained and I thought that she should be house trained by now. So that's the main reason I'm making today's video, is for all the people who just got their little doxy puppy and the house training isn't as easy as you thought it would be. I wanna share my experience with you guys so that maybe if you're relating to something I went through, I can give you some tips and tricks that help me get through it. I'm not a dog trainer. I have zero animal qualifications. So like I always say, take my advice with a grain of salt. This is just advice from my experience. It's not advice from any education or training or anything like that. This isn't a blueprint for exactly how you should house train your dog. It's just my experience and what I did, what worked, what didn't work. And then you can decide for yourself what route you want to take when it comes to house training. Now I'm rambling, so I'm just gonna get right into it. I'm gonna tell you the journey of from when I first got Stella to now. Starting at 8 weeks old, that's when I picked Stella up. Obviously, she was not house trained. The breeder I got her from didn't start any house training. The puppies just went on their puppy pads in their pen, or when they were outside, they went outside. So I was starting from scratch. And like I said in my crate training video, I started crate training the day I got Stella. I was slowly introducing her to the crate. So my mindset going into house training was that I was gonna crate train her, I was gonna skip the puppy pads and just go straight to trying to train her to only go outside. Because I had read a few things that said that puppy pads are just stalling your dog learning to go outside. Because then first you have to train them to go on the puppy pads, and then you have to train them, okay, now you don't get puppy pads, now you only have to go outside, and then it makes it confusing. I don't know how true that is, but that's what I heard, and that was the idea that I went with. So I didn't use puppy pads at all, but I don't know if that was the right decision. Maybe it was, maybe it wasn't, but if you do want to use puppy pads, I did find a tool that I wish I found earlier, and I shared it in another video. It's a puppy pad tray. I just think the idea of it is so perfect because it helps keep things cleaner if you are going the puppy pad route. And if I knew about this tool back then, I probably would have used it with my puppy. So if you guys are doing puppy pads, I will link that down below so you guys can take a look at it. But anyways, the crate training and house training rules that I started with were, I was gonna take Stella out every half hour that she was awake, and when she slept, I would let her out as soon as she woke up. And then for crate training, she wasn't on a crate schedule, but I would leave her in the crate, and then every time I took her out of the crate, I would take her outside first. I think both of these strategies really helped because I did find that when she woke up from naps and when she got out of her crate were the two times that she was most likely to go to the bathroom. So just taking her out on those two instances really helped with the house training. But there were still a lot of circumstances where I was in the middle of playing with her, or she was just walking around and being nice and calm, and then all of a sudden she'd go to the bathroom on the floor, even if she had just gone out like 10 minutes before. And in the beginning, I didn't think much of it because she was only 8 weeks old. That's pretty much like blaming a newborn for going in their diaper. They don't have the training or the physical capability to hold it at that age, so I let it go for a while. I still continued with letting her out as frequently as possible. My goal was every 30 minutes. And then throughout the night, when she was a brand new puppy, 8 weeks old, I would set 2 alarms in the night to take her out of the crate and go to the bathroom just to try and avoid accidents in the crate. Another thing that I read is that dogs don't like going to the bathroom in the place that they sleep. For example, a crate or a pen or wherever their bed is, they avoid it because they want a nice clean sleeping space. And I found that to be true with Stella. She didn't have very many accidents in her crate at all. And I think the bathroom breaks in the middle of the night really helped her to learn to hold it while she's sleeping. So that was all that I did for probably the first month or so. So at this point, Stella's about 3 months old. And I'd say between the age of 3 to 5 months is when accidents started cutting down, but they were still very frequent. At this point, I was taking her out once every hour, or as soon as she got out of her crate and as soon as she woke up from nap. Stella also wasn't allowed to roam free at this age. I would either have her on a leash in the house, or I would be sitting in a room with closed doors and watching her. But every time I was doing that, she would still just randomly have accidents. And around 5-6 months old is when I started to get frustrated with it, because I felt like I was being so consistent with taking her out regularly, and I felt like I was doing everything right with crate training and like giving her, I would put her in her crate for an hour or two at a time just to give her, one, a break to relax, but also because I knew that she wasn't having accidents in her crate, and then I would take her out to go to the bathroom. But sometimes I would take her out of her crate, take her outside to go to the bathroom, and she wouldn't go, and then I would still just let her play and roam, and she would almost always have an accident within about 10 minutes. So that's when I added a new rule that really helped with the house training. So this is a big tip. When she finished her crate time and I took her outside to go to the bathroom and she wouldn't go, instead of letting her play, I would put her back into the crate for another 5-10 minutes, and then I would take her out again, give her another chance to go to the bathroom. If she didn't go, then it was back into the crate, and I would repeat that same thing every 5 to 10 minutes. I'd take her out and give her a chance to go to the bathroom, but until she went to the bathroom, she wasn't allowed to play and roam free. And this cut back the accidents by quite a bit. And I'd say by 6 months, she was about 75% house trained. She was fairly reliable. She was starting to understand the concept of go to the bathroom outside, don't go inside, but she was still having enough accidents that I wouldn't consider her house trained, which was frustrating because at 6 months old, almost all puppies are house trained by that age, or at least about 95% there. So I felt like Stella was really far behind with that. But one thing that I never ever did was punish her or get mad at her in any way for the accidents inside. Some people say that you should rub your dog's nose in their accident, or you know, you yell at them or have some kind of punishment so they know, okay, I went to the bathroom inside and that was bad. But I decided not to do that for two reasons. One, because I just don't want that kind of relationship with my dog. I want to avoid punishing at all costs. I like the positive reinforcement training style. I do think balance training works for other things, but when it comes to house training, I think it is all about consistency and it's the owner's responsibility to house train. And the second reason I didn't punish her for going in the house is because I read or I heard or watched in a video that when you punish your dog for going to the bathroom, even if it's inside, even if it's bad, then they get a negative connotation with going to the bathroom. They don't understand that you're mad at them for where they did it. They just think, I went to the bathroom, I got in trouble, going to the bathroom is bad. And that can lead to other problems because then when you go to take your dog out in the morning and you're waiting for them to go to the bathroom and they're not going, it's because they're thinking, oh, they're watching, I don't wanna go because last time I got in trouble when I went. Again, I don't know how true it is, but that's what I heard and I still think I believe that. So my tip would be don't punish your dog, take responsibility. When your dog has an accident in the house, 99% of the time it is your fault because you're not letting them out frequently or you're giving them opportunities to have accidents. You should minimize all opportunities to have accidents in the house. But anyways, back to the timeline. Stella is about 7 months old now, 75% trained, but still having frequent enough accidents that is frustrating. So at this point, I started a schedule. By now, she had a little bit of a pattern of in the morning, she does a pee and a poop. Around lunch, she does another pee. And then in the afternoon, it's a pee and a poop. And then before bed, a pee. That is a standard day of bathroom breaks for Stella. And my schedule at the time was just taking her out randomly throughout the day. So I thought maybe if I make a schedule, then her body and her bladder and her bowels will get used to this schedule and they will know like you have to hold it for this amount of time. So that's what I started doing at the same time every morning, the same time every lunch, afternoon, and nighttime, I would take her out. And that's when I noticed another step in improvement in her house training was when there was a consistent schedule and I actually stuck to it. It was way more predictable when she'd need to go to the bathroom, and I started noticing that on days where I would accidentally miss a scheduled time for her bathroom break, she would have an accident almost to the T on the time that I was supposed to take her out. So that's when I knew the schedule is working and this isn't Stella's fault. This is just me having to take responsibility and actually sticking to the schedule and being consistent. So I did that very strict schedule for another month or so. And that's when I would say Stella became officially house trained. She has still had accidents since then, but almost every time she has an accident, it's my own fault for breaking the schedule. For example, the last time she had an accident was about a month ago, and it was because I woke up in the morning and my routine had changed that day. So when I woke up, I forgot to take her out right away. So I started getting ready and making breakfast and everything, which usually I let Stella out and then I start doing all that stuff. So then Stella had an accident while I was making my breakfast, and immediately I realized, oh yeah, I forgot to take her out. So it's only situations like that where Stella has accidents, and they're very, very rare now. So if you're house training a puppy right now, there is hope, there is light at the end of the tunnel. It just takes a lot of patience. So in conclusion, some tips that I have for house training are: use a crate. Your puppy is less likely to go to the bathroom inside the crate than if they're free roaming. So when you know your puppy has to go to the bathroom soon and they're not going outside, don't just let them roam the house. Put them in a crate and then try again. Tip number two is have a consistent schedule. So when you first get your puppy, obviously you're gonna need a lot more bathroom breaks in the day. I would say like 10 to 20 or every half hour or something like that. And then you can slowly break it down as they get older, as their body is able to hold their pee longer. Obviously you can start to extend that and then eventually get on a very consistent schedule that works for your dog and works for your lifestyle. Tip number three is don't punish your dog for going in the house. It's very confusing for the dog. It can lead to other problems. And punishment isn't needed for house training. 99% of the time a dog has an accident, it's the owner's fault. So instead of punishing your dog, punish yourself and change your schedule to make it work for your dog. Tip number four is eliminate all the scenarios and all the spots that your dog tends to go for their bathroom breaks. For example, Stella loves fluffy rugs or carpets of any kind, as do majority of dogs, because carpets resemble grass. So if you notice that your dog is always peeing on the same rug, then roll up that rug for a month or a few weeks until your puppy learns that that's not where they're supposed to go, and I guarantee that will cut back on accidents. And tip number five is clean up properly. I would get a pet specific cleaner. The one I use is Resolve. I'll link that down below. You need one that gets rid of the odor, because when a dog is walking around the house and then they smell a spot that they went to the bathroom before, then they associate that with their bathroom spot, the same way they do with puppy pads. So if it's not properly cleaned, then your dog thinks that's where they're supposed to go because that's where they went last time. And my last and final tip is be patient. This breed is very stubborn, and even though they will learn what they're supposed to do, it doesn't mean that they're always gonna do what they're supposed to do. If you choose to get this breed, you need to realize that you're signing up for a difficult house training journey. And if it doesn't happen to be that, then that's awesome and you're very lucky. But I do get a lot of messages from people saying that their puppy is 5 or 6 months old and they're still struggling with house training, and I get it. It is so frustrating, and there were times where I just felt so defeated and I honestly wanted to cry. But this is what you signed up for. This is a responsibility that you take on. So you need to be patient. You can't take it out on your dog. You need to take responsibility and be consistent and set up a schedule and set up scenarios that work for both you and your dog. But that is it for today's video on house training. I think Stella slept through the entire thing. I hope you guys learned something new. And if you are on your house training journey right now, I am so sorry, and I hope it gets better. It will get better if you're patient and consistent. If you liked this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up down below and hit subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.